تابعين. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وعملا وفهما وذوقا وحالا في الدين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وآله في الأولين، وصل على سيدنا محمد وآله في الآخرين، وصل على سيدنا محمد وآله في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين، صل على سيدنا محمد وآله حتى ترث الأرض ومن عليها وأنت خير الوارثين، وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. I'm very honored again to be here at this blessed masjid of Abu Ahmad, Sheikh Mahmoud, all of good people here in this community. It feels feels home. My wife is that, no, everybody is from like Sham or Lebanon or Syria, but يعني. ولا هي الأمة كلها واحدة سبحان الله، لكن there's a feel for this place. So Allah bless you. You are blessed. والشكر تدوم النعم لئن شكرتم. اي والله لا أزيدنكم. يعني 10 minutes or so that Sheikh Omar told me, right? Something like that. Sheikh Mahmouda. Right? Sheikh Ali. عفوا أنا. Sheikh Ali. Sheikh Ali آسف. هذا الصيام ترى أخذ علي شوي. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. واستعينوا بالصبر والصلاة وإنها لكبيرة إلا على الخاشعين. الآية الكريمة في سورة البقرة، استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة. ذهب كثير من المفسرين إلى تعريف الصبر بالصيام، لأن العرب تسمي الشيء بلازمه وتطلق على الجزء الكل وعلى الكل الجزء، هي تسمية العرب. فمن لوازم الصيام الصبر، فكأن الله تعالى يقول واستعينوا بالصوم والصلاة. Oh, sorry. Somebody is looking at me. He was to be in English. طيب تمام أنا آسف. I apologize. الآية الله says استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة. Seek help from صبر and صلاة. Seek help from صبر and صلاة. Since the ayah is saying that, it means we really need help. Otherwise, the Quran would not give you a solution if there is no problem already. The problem is we are helpless people. We need help. Where does this help come from? Allah says, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ. Seek help from صبر and صلاة. صبر يعني patient or patience, afwan. وصلاة صلاة. لكن many of the مفسرين say الصبر in this ayah is really a psalm. As if Allah is saying, seek help from sawm and salah. That both will help you. شوف. طبعا, we go to the sunnah of Sayyidina sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. كان إذا همه أمر. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If something happens, فزع إلى الصلاة. Went to الصلاه. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Right? So that is already also established in the sunnah. الصيام also, يعني, you know, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم schedule of صيام was always almost, يعني, every month you have specific days, الأيام البيض, سورة شعبان, etc, etc, etc. حتى في الحديث الحسن where he صلى الله عليه وسلم gives the advice to those young people who are not married. Remember? يا معشر الشباب, من استطاع منكم الباءة فليتزوج ومن لم يستطع فعليه بالصوم فإنه له وجاء. الحديث يحسن إن شاء الله. طيب يعني oh young people whoever who amongst you can get married if you can't get married what should you do meanwhile fast صوم استعينوا بالصوم والصلاة وإنها لكبيرة الصوم والصلاة ترى not easy except on those who are conscientious of Allah خاشعين لأنه it seems that الصوم والصلاة require that خشوع that presence with Allah عز وجل طيب يعني why Allah عز وجل tells us as في صحيح البخاري ومسلم الحديث إلا الصوم ولفظ مسلم إلا الصيام فإنه لي وأنا أجزي به they said first because الصيام liberates يعني يحرر الإنسان من رتق العبودية how so how does it liberate you from slavery how ما هو الإنسان enslaved to his desires enslaved takes تتحكم فيه شهوته enslaved to his lower nafs desires يعني what the مؤرخين some of historians say I'll take two more minutes now هارون الرشيد الخليفة العباسي he said he had three جواري three يعني maids that he really liked they sing for him because he enjoys them he would he says among the lines the poems that he says ملك الثلاث الجاريات عناني وحللنا في قلبي بكل مكاني he says these three women they control me هارون he says and they are in my heart in every place مالي تطيعني البرية كلها or يعني now the line doesn't say he says the whole world obeys me وأطيعهن وهن في عصياني and I also obey them but they always disobey me how come these there three maids are supposed to obey me I am the whole world obeys me he says and I obey them but they disobey me ما ذاك إلا لأن سلطان الهوى وبه قوين أعز من سلطاني he says this is because I tell you the reason سلطان الهوى I have love for them that makes me weak and that makes them stronger than me so I fall for my weakness and they become stronger than me even though I'm the Khalifa الصوم liberates يعني أنت now you cannot eat you cannot drink حتى your spouse you cannot approach during the month during the day كذا it liberates you from things you think you need delusionally with oh I need to eat right now otherwise I'm collapsing I need to drink I need I can't talk I can't do I can't no it liberates you from all these things frees you from what you think you really need to collect you entirely on Allah that's the only need you have ايوان so we don't go much more the second thing is الصوم also grows in us جانب الإحسان حديث اللي رواه الإمام البخاري وأذرز الصحيح وحديث جبريل you all know the حديث قال ما الإحسان قال أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك إحسان is that you worship Allah as if you're seeing him if you don't see him he sees you that's oftentimes difficult and mostly in غفلة الله يعفو عنا may Allah forgive all of us we are in غفلة الله أكبر we pray and we recite لكن الصيام comes what and does what comes and makes you observe Allah سبحانه وتعالى unconsciously you will not drink you will not eat nobody sees you you can drink and you can eat at home you can stop by anything nobody sees you لكن you don't why conscious subconsciously you are with Allah سبحانه وتعالى تمام خلاص عشان ما اطول تمام يعني اخذ الشيخ انه قلت 10 دقائق لا ترويح انا الشيخ علي جمعه اللي بيقوله بمشي عليه حبيبي ما انه لانه البيوت يعني واحد ياتي البيوت من مو هيك ابو احمد لا اله الا الله طيب طيب ما هو هذا من الضعف، ضعف الإنسان سبحان الله. أنه لذلك من خواص، من خصائص سيدنا صلى الله عليه وآله وأصحابه وأزواجه وسلم أنه أوتي جوامع الكلم، الحديث الصحيح right؟ جوامع الكلم يعني what؟ He says few things صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم وسفايز. تعال إحنا we need books to say same things، وحتى we will not get there. صلى الله عليه يا سيدي يا رسول الله. فأول شيء the first thing we said it liberates. The second thing we said what؟ جانب التزكية، هذا جانب الإحساني، مراقبة الله عز وجل right؟ The مراقبة، the observation of Allah. إحنا في غفلة، most of the time في غفلة، نسأل الله العافية. لكن الصيام pushes you حتى without you wanting to or without you asking for it, it pushes you to worship him as if you're seeing him. You will never break your fast. But why? You can, صحيح, but you won't. Why? Subconsciously, you know Allah is watching you. Why would you do that? If we can bring this exercise to the salah siyam, we observe Allah in our salah, afwan, our zakah, our muamalat, our dealing with each other, وكذا وإلى آخره. We become amongst the awliya of Allah. أن تعبد الله, that you worship Allah as if you are seeing him. If you are not seeing him, he is seeing you. This psalm now brings us this aspect. So the reason I'm saying expand this topic now, you know you're fasting, you don't break your fast because subconsciously you realize Allah knows you, Allah sees you, Allah hears you. Same thing now when you deal with people, when you do things, when you study, when you work. Tamam. The other thing also janib ihsani or janib yani spiritual, if you want like to call it tazkawi. How so? الصيام helps us automatically in three things that are difficult for us. I call them cardiotoxic. طبعاً not يعني from an allopathic perspective. لا, from a spiritual perspective. حتى maybe from allo, I don't know, maybe. Cardiotoxic يعني toxic for the heart. How so? فضول الكلام وفضول المنام وفضول الطعام وفضول مخالطة الأنام. Unnecessary food, unnecessary talk, unnecessary sleep, unnecessary mingling. Allah, don't tell me أنت يعني شيخ you are anti-social. لا لا حبيبي, please be social. Be social all you want. لكن يعني the idea is that when you gather on Allah Azza wa Jalla. Remember the hadith al-sahih where Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, among the seven people that will be granted a shade in the day of judgment, where no one is granted a shade but those whom Allah gives, people who gather, رجلان اجتمعا على الله وافترق. You gather on Allah and you separate on Allah. Yeah, it means something beneficial, something that helps you in the dunya and in the akhirah. الصيام رمضان, you don't have now much tolerance for things that are not beneficial. Automatically, you say, look, I want to occupy my time in good things. So that's unnecessary mingling. Unnecessary eating. Alhamdulillah, we developed a habit of 24-hour snacking. Right? We snack, and after the snack, we snack. And after the snack, we snack again. And the snacks nowadays becomes a meal. يعني ما شاء الله full meal الحمد لله. رمضان regulates right now. فضول الطعام it becomes regulatory. You all know الحديث اللي رواه أحمد ورواه ابن حبان في صحيحه والحاكم authenticated it as well. والترمذي declared it حسن صحيح right. حديث ما عندي يكذب where he says the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said ما ملأ ابن آدم وعاء شرا من بطنه. The human being did not fill anything more worse than filling his stomach. بحسب ابن آدم لقيمات يقمن صلبه. Suffice for you many bites. فإن كان ولا بد فثلث لطعامه وثلث لشرابه وثلث لنفسه. If you have to then divide one third for your food, one third for your drinks, one third for breathing. So it regulates. So you come to me, no, كل أدرى بثلثه. Everyone knows his own third. So don't now tell people, hey, you ate now two thirds already. لا, أنت, you don't know. Maybe your third is different than someone else's third. تمام؟ هذا فضول الطعام. الطعام becomes lighter. Yeah, we should not turn Ramadan into a food festival. Decent, nice, good, Bismillah. والبركة in Ramadan. Also, the Ramadan brings us now, shufa, it brings us together. Family comes together to eat. Al-Masjid comes together to eat. People come together to eat. Subhanallah. وهذا, this is something that we're missing, we've been missing for a while. طيب. فضول الكلام, excessive or unnecessary talk. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, الحديث الصحيح, you all know الحديث, فإن سابه أحد أو شاتمه فليقل إني امرؤ صائم. يعني there will be people who will harass you, people who will engage you in a bad way. They want a reaction out of you. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam does not want us to be reactionaries. Right? لا لا أنت, why should you be defined by other people? Until you have your own definition, ya Habibi. You are dignified. Don't let others define you. If they slander you, if they call you names, do not be defined by them. Tell yourself. Don't tell them, Tara, listen, I am Saim. Otherwise, I would have told you other million things, like what you told me and others, and that you defeat the purpose. Tell yourself before you react to their negativity. I am fasting. Inni mru'un Saim. Yani, the idea of Inni Saim, to polish yourself, to calm it down from wanting to be reactionary, not to tell the opponent that you are fasting. He doesn't care, you're not fasting for him, and he doesn't care whether you fast or not necessarily. ففي هذا تهذيب also, there is refinement of the nafs in this as well. And then also, المنام, excessive sleep. طبعا, now in the Arab world we say, النوم سلطان. And no, sleeping is sultan, true, and no, لكن the idea in في Ramadan we have التراويح, alhamdulillah, القيام, and you're doing it, mashallah, every day. Very nice. Now you're taking time that you usually maybe, not everybody, maybe you did not pray in that time, now you're praying in that time. لكن extra, حتى سيدنا عمر رضي الله عنه mentions this. He says, وَالَّتِي يَنَامُونَ عَنْهَا أَفْضَلُ. لما الحديث اللي رواه, it is narrated in many places, so it has an authentic sanad. الفريابي narrates the whole story complete في الصيام, لكن الحديث مبعثر في كتب السنة, مفرق يعني, where Ibn Abbas was with سيدنا عمر رضي الله عنه. يعني سيدنا عمر invited عبدالله بن العباس. ترى عبدالله بن العباس يعني at that time, mind you, يعني أنا أرجوك, how old was ابن عباس يعني؟ ما هو ابن عباس was 10 years when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم passed away. يعني كم كان عمر ابن عباس في خلافة عمر؟ في صدر خلافة عمر كان عمر ابن عباس about 12 years, 13 years. لكن سيدنا عمر كان يقدمه. سيدنا عمر used to bring him with the shuyukh of the Ansar wal Muhajireen, who asks him questions. Tamam. It seems one day he invited him. وطبعاً هذا من القيادة, also leadership. سيدنا عمر is a leader. He brings people who he knows who he, this young man. حتى he asks him a question that the Sahaba don't know, to show them that he knows what he knows, right? About إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح, you all know the event, maybe some other time. So I don't make this long for you. تمام. Abdullah ibn Abbas was with Sayyidina Umar, and it seems in his home, the people in the masjid were praying Taraweeh. He sees them leaving. He tells them, the prayer that they leave, التي ينامون عنها أفضل. Now they go to sleep, and the qiyam of al-layl at night towards the end is better than this one. So now what we do, today, after you do taraweeh, you're going to go home. Before you go home, before you go to bed, two rak'ah.
Allahu Akbar, two rak'ah. Two rak'ah and then sleep. You're going to sleep anyway. Lakin before that, make your wudu. Don't let shaitan tell you, now you have to make wudu again, or kada, or no. Do wudu, two rak'ah. Right? And then after the two rak'ah, sleep. Now you have done qiyam at the beginning of the night, and you have done qiyam at the end of the night. If you do more than two khair, lakin this too is nice. You, inshallah, enjoy it. Sayyidina Umar used to say, it's better than the ones in the early of the night. Tamam. As-siyam gives us that opportunity. There's motivation. But then let me finish with this. Shuf. Laylatul Qadri khayrun min... Alf shahar, you named it. طيب يا حبيبي ألف شهر, how many years, يعني 1,000 months, يعني 83 years, تمام؟ طيب أنت, how long do usually people live? Inshallah, you all live a million years if you like. Whatever you like to live, may Allah give you with إيمان and health, بس يعني, huh? Not without إيمان and health, يا رب, تمام؟ لكن average people, 83 years they live? طيب, 83 years, والله nice. You have one night in this month better than your whole life. Better than living your 83 years. This opportunity here that we have. One night better than all of your life. Take advantage of it. Don't let this Ramadan come and go like the past Ramadan. You all know, especially with COVID, we all lost people that were very close to us in the past 3 years. فالله عز وجل gave us the opportunity to be present in this Ramadan. Don't let this Ramadan go by like any other Ramadan. There may be a night in this Ramadan that's better than your whole life. Be exposed to that. Ask Allah عز وجل for help. Ask Allah for mercy. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى, I ask Allah عز وجل for me and you to grant us the best of this Ramadan, to forgive us all in this Ramadan, and to grant us all guidance in this Ramadan, to protect our children in this Ramadan, to have mercy on our parents and our grandparents in this Ramadan, and to remember with his mercy those who nobody remembers anymore, who died and passed on and are forgotten. Ya Rabbal Alameen, you don't forget anyone. So grant those who are forgotten your mercy and rahmah, Ya Rabbal Alameen. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to grant us the Laylatul Qadr, that we actually live it, we actually see it, we actually benefit from it, and to grant healing to all humanity, humanity that are suffering today. May Allah grant them all healing. May Allah guide all people and then bless them all. وجزاكم الله تعالى خيرا وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله والحمد لله رب العالمين. Yeah.